So, look, I've had Nancy Mace on the show. I've had no reason to dislike her, but let's not pretend that she's a super conservative. She's a moderate, y'all. I hope you pay attention to her record before we start like calling people like Chip Roy who are or Thomas Massey who are exponentially more conservative rhinos as compared to her moderate record. That's number one. Number two, she and Vivek Ramaswamy are in a competition to see who can waffle the most. This is why people are criticizing Nancy Mace. Again, welcome back to the show. Dana Loesch here with you. I know, Representative Spartz? I met her in Georgia when I was in Georgia helping to get out the vote during special election or midterms? Can't remember. And I totally disagree with what she was saying about this whole speaker fight, but I like her, and she's always been consistent. Notice that she's not getting a lot of criticism. A lot of these other eight Republicans that colluded and voted with Democrats, you can get mad about how I'm saying it, but that's true. You know, come on. They're not getting criticized because they've been pretty consistent on stuff. She hasn't been. So she's being criticized because she's inconsistent. And I'm just not going to allow people to conflate that and misrepresent it and claim that, oh, it's because suddenly she's this stalwart conservative and she's always opposed McCarthy and that's why they are targeting her. They're not targeting her, by the way. They're disagreeing with her. People who call disagreements, and usually it's progressives who do this and Republicans who are really progressives and are faking that they're Republicans, they say that they're being targeted or attacked when they're being disagreed with because their hypocrisy is so astounding. Yeah, it's pretty damning. So she's being criticized, and I don't see how it's not justifiable because she's been so ridiculously inconsistent on this. That's what people are saying. They're just simply pointing out that she's going to wherever she thinks the power is. Is that not part of the problem that we have with people in D.C.? Is they don't stand on principle and they go wherever, you know, they smell the scent of power in the wind and that's where they go. Is that not why we have a problem with most people in D.C.? So why is that any different here? Because she did one thing that maybe affirmed one stance that someone has on this one instance? Because that sounds pretty weak. She's not a hardcore conservative. She never has been. And I know that she's kind of been, I think gun owners gave her, I was trying to remember what rating they gave her. I think it was like a 92% or something. They had revised it. And, you know, she's better on guns than most Republicans. But I don't like when you say, we got to strengthen background checks and do all that stuff. And she's literally verbatim. I have the press release that she has that's still up on her official House site where she used that phrase. So I kind of bristle when I hear stuff like that. She's been pretty moderate on abortion. She had a very difficult time defending her stance on The View. That is what it is. People have got to stop attacking their fellow countrymen when their fellow countrymen point out without any emotion, very obvious things about these political people in office. Now, like I've said, I don't have anything against, I don't dislike Nancy Mace. I don't dislike, you know, I don't have a problem with the eight Republicans that were going off like Victoria Spartz. I like her. I've met her. She's a firebrand. I don't have anything bad to say about her. She was hardcore. She was one of the eight. But you know why, again, one of the why she's not getting criticism is because this chick is consistent. Victoria Spartz has always been consistent. That's why she's not getting any shade. Biggs, he's not catching shade because he's always been consistent. Mace has been inconsistent. And now she's trying to encourage people. She's telling people, the establishment's coming after me. No, they're not. These are grassroots conservatives with records more conservative than yours, with a longer history of conservatism, who are pointing out that you literally waffled so that you could be power adjacent. Now, come on, be honest about that, because if you're going to lie about something that obvious, what the hell else are you going to lie about? That's out there for all of us to see. Why make stuff more difficult for yourself? See, this is what I don't get. Why in the hell do people lie about stupid stuff like this? Just own it. Just be like, yeah, I said that. And you know what? I changed my mind because of this. people will be a lot more forgiving of something like that than you gaslighting them, acting like they're rhinos because, or they're the establishment after you, because they pointed out that legit, just a handful of months prior, you hated Matt Gaetz. She was the strongest, his strongest critic. It just blows the mind. This is why I hate DC. Some of you people ask me, why would you run for office? I'd be beating the hell out of everybody. I'd be already be beating people with canes. There's no way. No way. I wouldn't want this job. I would not represent anyone who voted for me. There's no way. You people are crazy. But this is my whole point. Sparks and these others, they've been consistent. Mace hasn't been. And that's why people are criticizing her. She's bringing in the establishments after me to try to give herself cover. She's using that as a dog whistle. You know what I hate? I hate it when progressives call everything racist, and I don't like it when two-faced politicians call everything establishment or rhino. It is the same damn thing, just a different variable. Especially when they use those accusations against people like Chip Roy or Thomas Massie. Now, I had Chip Roy on this program yesterday, and I asked him everything. If you did not watch that interview, you need to go back on YouTube or Facebook, and you need to watch it. And I do mean to be bossy. I see people, I had a friend of mine who was going off about Roy, and I said, before you open your mouth, you might want to shut up for a second. Actually, listen to what the man's got to say here before you go misrepresenting his positions like some damn communist. That's what the commies do. I don't aim to try to be different from commies by adopting their commie behavior. That's just me. Like, if you're going to adopt their commie behavior, hell, when are you going to stop? You can go for confiscating all our wealth, too? Going to go for taking the guns? Like, when does it stop? So, he addressed the whole thing with the appropriations bills. Because remember, and I'm not defending McCarthy. I'm defending good people like Massey and Roy, who have super conservative records, and they're getting called rhinos because they're saying, wait a minute, this is actually what happened. And he talked about the whole myth of Ukraine funding in there. He addressed all of that. And I highly encourage you to go and watch that interview if you hadn't. But throwing out things like, oh, the establishment's after me, that's a dog whistle to try to obfuscate what you actually did. You're trying to hide what you did. You're muddying the water here. And you're using that as a shield against people who are raising legitimate questions. Like, what made you change? That's always been my big issue, for instance, with Ramaswamy. I don't mind people who change their mind. Hell, is that not the point of what we do? Isn't the whole point of what we do getting people to agree with us? So why would you excoriate someone who finally agrees with you? However, this is where I question the authenticity of it. When you can't give me what it is that made you do a 180, when you cannot show me your pathway of thought to get to your new position, that's when I got a little red flag that goes off and I feel like you're pandering to me. And I don't like that. Do you like being pandered to? I don't like being pandered to. I don't like it when somebody, a politician, tells me one thing and they do another. That's why we're in this position. So this is my big complaint with all this. No, it's not fair, nor is it accurate for her to say the establishment's at. Girl, you are the establishment. You have a moderate record. Go look up her record. Why are we doing this? This is so stupid. I mean, I look at this stuff, and I look back. I went back, and I was looking at her votes on this and that, big spending votes, all this other stuff. And, you know, like, for instance, she co-sponsored the Fairness for All Act. It was anti-discriminatory protections to alphabet people. That's a moderate thing to put out there, right? Why are we doing stuff? But that's what she did. That's an actual bill that she legit co-sponsored. Okay. And, I mean, really, you're going to, the Fairness for All Act? And then accuse other people of being the establishment? What? I don't get it. I don't understand that. And she tried to say that, oh, no, well, the Freedom for All Act, we're trying to protect the conscience rights of, you know, religious institutions, except the bill didn't do that at all. businesses that had more than like 10 employees were subject to the whole definition of public accommodation, thus forced to accommodate. So she literally sponsored a bill, that bill. How is that a conservative position? So no, you don't get to call other people the establishment when you're doing stuff like this. That's just one. I mean, do you guys want me to spend the rest of the show going through this? Because I'm well prepared to do it. I'm like going back and forth on, do I want to dump all of this in a piece for Substack and just throw it out there? I mean, I'd really like to focus on some of this other stuff, but I'm not going to sit here and let people misrepresent themselves. And the other thing that I don't like is that these people know that y'all work. Okay? They know that you're out there being busy. You're working because somebody, hell, somebody's got to pay the $127 billion grad school debt for all the government workers that Biden just bought off. So, you know, they get that you're busy. You don't have time to wade in to the petty power struggles of these dippy politicians. And they're counting on that. They're counting on you not knowing the everyday minutiae. And they want to play on that and try to sell you a load of something else. I don't like that either. So, I really don't like it when I see politicians do it. I feel like it's insulting to your intelligence and your time. Question everything. Even me, question everything. I always tell you, this is why I tell you where I am up front on everything. So you know exactly how to gauge me. The candidates I like, the issues I like. Everyone else out there tries to sell you a line of BS. This is exactly why I come out of the gate and I tell you where I am. I'm paid to have opinions, so it'd be stupid if I didn't. But some of these people out there need to respect their voters and their audiences a little bit more and be honest with y'all.